Hi everyone, Lisa here from Forest City Stitching. I hope everyone had a good week. It is much later than I usually film. It's about 6 o'clock. And I'm very sweaty because I was just baking some muffins. My house is a little bit warmer than it needs to be right now. Who knew we would break a sweat from baking? Yeah, it's Olympics 24/7 here in our household, so that is exciting. Yeah, it's been warm. Went for a run this morning. I went on Katie the Novel Stitcher's Zoom meeting for our book club, so I finished the book this afternoon, so just in the nick of time. It was a good book. It was Funny Story by Emily Henry, and yeah, it was a good read for sure. And I don't think I know much more else that's been going on. Nothing too exciting, so that is good. Coming to the end of Jolly July, which is good because I've been juggling a lot here with my Christmas stitching, and now with the Olympics, juggling some other challenges that I'm trying to do. Again, these are all self-made challenges or expectations, but challenges nonetheless. So let's get in to the stitching. Actually, before I do that, why don't we announce the winner of Flooding All the Way Glow by Bent Creek. And it is Sugar Plum Stitcher. I know you comment a lot, so thank you. I will try to make sure I put my email address in the drop down box below. So send me an email with your mailing address and I will get that in the mail. Excellent. Okay. Let's start off by going back to last Sunday because I think I filmed before stitching. I've only got a few stitches in today, so I didn't even bring that piece. We'll just look at that next week. So I brought out Home for Christmas again. I feel like Saturday, Sunday. Oh, okay. Home for Christmas was on the Jolly July and I just moved things around. Alright. Perfect. And I did more of the border and these peppermints. So I think I only have like two more bands to do. That's almost done. Looks good. Yeah. Boy, I'm sweaty. Right, and then I also worked on Under the Sea. This was a few days this week that I worked on that. This was for a prompt with fish. So that's how that's looking. I think there's something that we're off there, but that's okay. All right, I got a bunch in this. I'm gonna switch bags, I think, after this and move, because these are a lot of my Jolly July projects in here. And it's really getting too tight, so I think I'm just going to do a little swaparoo here with, I have a Kaylee Tent Stitch bag from the sewing shop. I think I might throw everything in that instead because it is a bigger bag. Alright, I'm just going to go through all the, oops, I don't have a picture for this. So, Tall Treats by Blue Flower. Got a little bit of work. Not too much, but a little bit. You can tell that I've now run out of Tour de France stitching because now things got kind of the, just touched a bare minimum. Sure, we can look at this next. Mary Sloth Miss by Tiny Modernist. I don't think I'm going to do the words, I'm just going to do the little sloth. Added in some greenery there. Again, just a bare minimum. That one got moved around a lot because I was supposed to start just on Thursday. Thursday was our anniversary and we went out for dinner, which was fine, and then I had a terrible headache, so then I just went to bed. So things got moved around. I do have a new start, Mouse's Christmas Decorating by Tiny Modernist. I actually bought this twice, once in this form and then once in PDF in error. And that's how that one's looking. This is on an 18 count vintage country mocha. I need to get some more of. Okay, so let's tuck all this stuff back in here for safe travels. Yeah, so that was that. And then Jolly July, Cassie the Cow came out. There are a few stitches, how she's looking. I'm also out of this Petty Point fabric, so I might need to get more of that as well. So I'm just kind of zooming through these. About as fast as I pulled them out stitch. And then Silver Creek Sampler. My Christmas list. This one I couldn't find momentarily because it had got smooshed in behind all my other projects. I just worked on the word mistletoe. But that look is looking really good too. Okay, so then Friday, the Olympics started, which is wonderful. So I am participating in Stitch the Summer Olympics by the Naptime Stitcher. And then also there is another piece that I had to start because Karen the Stitching Owl showed it. And then I couldn't stop thinking about it. Even though I didn't really have any new starts available to me, is this one by Jardin Privé. Look at these gnomes. They are doing Olympic activities. Cute, huh? So there's a sal going on for this, which is 2024 Summer Olympics sal. So I jumped on that bandwagon. I didn't have any room for any new starts for this or the Tiny Modernist Mouse, but I had spots on my Jolly July calendar for 2 new starts. I just hadn't finished enough to gain those yet. But I decided to go in debt, if you will, with my new starts. And so no more new starts until I get, well, I finish at least 3 projects, 3 small projects to make up for this medium and small start. Or if I finish a medium, I don't know if that's, if I have anything close to a finish quite yet, that's a medium. Then that would count for this Olympic, the Olympic gnomes. But yeah, so I need to finish 3 to get out of my debt that I've created for myself. And then any other new starts will not happen until I get some other finishes. So I need to get back on the bandwagon. So I did start a lot this month, but I did finish a lot as well. So I have a good amount of finishes this year. And because a lot of my smalls that I finished, I doubled up to start a medium. I haven't gained to my whip count at all. Now come December, last half of December is kind of a free for all for whatever I do. And that's kind of where my whip count might increase a bit, but, so yeah, no, my plan to keep myself not going too crazy with new starts is still working, because if I didn't have any sort of plan or restraint, I wouldn't have any self-restraint. I would just start all the things. And let's be honest, I don't have room for all the things really that I already have started, but that's fine. It's fine. So I put my gnomes in this bag. I know it's Summer Olympics, but this is what I had, and it just fits in there. But yeah, he's cute. All right. So that's how this is looking. So this is on Moccasin by Fortnite Fabric. I thought Christmas List is on Moccasin, but you know what? I bet it's on the darker one, a Fortnite Fabric. I think I still have a little bit of it. I bet that's what it was on. So the reason I bring that up, because the netting is supposed to be in white. I had stitched it in white, but I couldn't see it at all. My husband agreed he couldn't see it. So it is more tone on tone. I changed that to 453. So like a shell gray, a very light shell gray. It's fine. It looks fine in person. Again, it's a netting. Okay. Maybe it doesn't look too great in this sunlight, but it's fine. I can see it better than I could the white. And again, it's knitting. And so depending on the gnomes, so obviously most of the white is going to be their beards and then the mushroom bases. So I think that will work for their beards and the mushroom bases if I need to. It's like a couple white butterflies, but maybe they'll be a different color butterfly. I believe this is 16 count. I think. I'm not confident on that, but I think. So that was for the first day of Stitch the Summer Olympics. So that was a new start. And then the second day of the Summer Olympics is something that's patriotic. So I chose This one from Maximum Cross Stitch from Stitch North last year. And I just did a couple lengths of thread. Not a big contribution of that one. But that's fine. So yeah, so that was for day two. Day three is stitch something related to summer. And then also Up Warriors is doing an Olympic challenge as well, which I'm just going to add to as I can. I'm not doing anything extra for that one. So that's just going to be a as I can situation. Yeah. I was just looking ahead to what else I had head slated. I am going to try to do the gnomes as much as I can. Which, yeah, they're going to pop up a little bit. Nine out of the prompts, if my math is right. Probably not right, but all right, that is enough rambling for me, I think. Next weekend, we are going to a cottage of my supervisor, my leader. Supposed to be kind of like a whole team was going to go. But it's just gonna be my husband and I and my leader and her husband, so yeah, which is fine, like we get along just fine, but yeah, so we're going for one night. It's about 4 hours away, so it's a long drive, and then halfway we're meeting my dad to give him my son for the night. So, or for the day, I should say. And yeah, that's all I know, I think. Hope everyone has a great week. And Sugar Plum Stitcher, make sure you send me your address.